R. Kelly remains in custody as he awaits his arraignment on the new federal charges against him.
Kelly was arrested Thursday on a 13-count indictment that includes sex crimes and obstruction of justice. Another indictment in New York charges him with racketeering and sex-related crimes. A judge is expected to rule on possible bail during a hearing tomorrow. Kelly was released on bail after he pleaded not guilty to state charges of sexually abusing three girls and a woman in Illinois. Joining us now live from downtown is R. Kelly's attorney, Steve Greenberg. Steve, thank you for joining us.
Good morning from the heat and humidity.
So, Steve, give us a perspective on it seems like a lot of charges here that R. Kelly's facing and his reaction.
Well, I mean, his reaction is he's devastated. I think it's piling on. It's virtually unprecedented. The charges go back two decades. There's no allegations that he's been with any minors or anything since the 90s. It's a repeat of the same state charges largely that he had back in the early 2000s. And we're going to fight the charges. We're hoping that the judge tomorrow sets bail. He's been out on bail on the state charges. These overlap those. He posted a significant amount of money. He's obviously not a flight risk. Everyone's known these charges are coming, and he hasn't fled. He's showed up for court. He turned himself in on the state charges, and we're confident that at the end of the day, he'll be out there singing and performing again.
Steve, if the government, if the prosecutors have these videos that potentially show people who are underage engaging in these acts with him, and they can prove that they are underage, how do you defend that? How do you go at that charge?
Well, there's a lot of different defenses. I don't want to get into the specifics of our strategy, but there's statute of limitations questions, there's authenticity questions, there's double jeopardy questions. There's a lot of things before you even get to the factual questions at trial. I have not yet seen the videos that the federal government is talking about. I know that there's sworn testimony from the young lady that was involved in the Cook County charges supposedly years ago, sworn testimony that it wasn't her, sworn testimony from her parents that it wasn't her. I don't know that the government would bring a charge based on people who are known they'd be saying they perjured themselves before, but we haven't gotten any of the evidence yet, so we gotta look at it. Convoluted, very complex.
These racketeering charges, this RICO law he's being charged on, you said it's a scary use of that law. Not appropriate?
No, it's not appropriate at all. So what RICO is RICO says that you've committed various state crimes and they sort of federalize it. It was originally designed for the mob and for the gangs. What they've said here is that in New York City, he committed a series of crimes by having sexual encounters with adults, adult women, consensual sexual encounters, and they could have caught a sexually transmitted disease. That's largely what those charges are predicated on. I think what I said last week, if R. Kelly is a RICO enterprise, then so are the Rolling Stones and Motley Crue and a host of other bands, the whole rock and roll industry.
Steve, so you have these charges coming from all angles now. You have a couple other associates of R. Kelly who have been charged as well. Do you worry that people in his inner circle might flip and turn on him?
I think there's people in his inner circle who have told stories to save themselves, probably gotten immunity, said things. I don't have their statements yet. Largely, I believe what they've said is not true. I don't know what the other defendants in the case are going to do. That's up to them.
All right, Steve Greenberg, R. Kelly's attorney, thanks for joining us this morning.
Thank you.